Hand hygiene, provide privacy, put my gloves on. Good morning, Jessica. My name is Shania. I'm from Harper College Nursing Student. I'm going to be doing a postpartum assessment, if that's okay with you. Yes, okay. I'm going to be pulling up for MR. Just be verifying your first, last name, date of birth, and if you have any allergies, okay? So if you please state your first, last name. Jessica, all right, good. Date of birth, 01/04/1988, good. Do you have any allergies? Yes, to penicillin? Correct. Okay, so upon talking to her, answering her questions, she is, her airway is clear, and her breathing seems unlabored. She's warm to the touch, and she, her skin color is, normal for ethnicity. And now I'm going to verbalize her that I'm going to next assess your heart, your lung sounds, and your bowel sounds. That's okay. Okay, so on a real person, I'd be doing it under the gown, but for this purpose, for showing you where I'm assessing, I'm going to be doing it over the gown. S1 and S2. I can hear the left up. Now I'm gonna hear the apical for 30 seconds. It is normal. Now I'm gonna hear the lung sounds. You can take a deep breath in, Jessica. Deep breath out. Deep breath in, deep breath out. Okay, so the lungs are bilaterally clear. On a real patient, I'd be assessing both the front and the back of the lung sounds. But for this purpose, I only did the front. All right, Jessica, thank you for letting me listen to your heart on lung sounds. Now I need to hear your bowel sounds. I'm going to be exposing your abdomen. If that's okay with you, I'm gonna keep the blanket on the bottom on your legs so you are warm. Okay? Is that okay? Alright, thank you. Alright, Jessica, I'm sorry if my stethoscope is cold. I'm just gonna hear your bowel sounds, okay? Alright, your bowel sounds are active and normal. Now, Jessica, we're also going to put this back down so you're more comfortable and warm. Next, I'm going to be assessing your breast. Individual, I'm going to assess one at a time. If that's okay with you, I'm going to expose the first breast. Okay? So I'm looking if it's soft and if there's any redness or cracks around the nipple. Soft, no redness, no cracks. How's the baby latching on? Good. Okay, that's good. Now I'm going to assess your other breast if that's okay with you. Good. Alright. It is soft. It does seem to be a little bit of redness and cracks. So next time the baby does latch, let me know. You can also, it's called the golden milk, which it's the colostrum, which has healing properties that you can put over the redness and the cracks that can help with the healing. Okay? That's the end of that assessment, Jessica. So we're going to again look at the abdomen. If that's okay with you, if I can expose your abdomen again. Like before, I'm gonna do the same thing with the blanket. Is that okay? Alright, so I'm gonna place my hand suprapubic bone above that. Also, since you delivered 24 hours ago, it should be this one should be at 1 centimeter from the umbilicus, okay? I'm gonna assess the fundus. Should be firm, okay? It is firm and it is midline, so that's good. I'm gonna bring this back so you're not exposed. The next step would be assessing the lochia, Jessica. Are you okay with me assessing that? Okay. Alright, so they said during report they told me that you changed it 30 minutes ago. So this is normal for 30 minutes ago. The color seems normal. There doesn't seem to be any odor, no abnormal odor. I'm gonna assess the laceration. Laceration, we're looking at Rita, which redness, you have mild redness, and then also edema, mild edema. We're looking at ecchymosis, bruising, seems to be a couple bruises. Looking for discharge. So I look underneath the pad. I'm also gonna turn the patient, ask if she can turn. I can assess that as well. So just seems to be also we're gonna assess for the approximation. Seems to be approximating nicely. Also, I can see that you have a hemorrhoid over here, Jessica. Just one though. Okay. Alright, so I'm just gonna put this back, dispose of my gloves, do hand hygiene. Put new gloves on. Okay, Jessica. I just have a couple of questions. Let me get you comfortable first by putting this blanket back on. First question is, when was your last bowel movement? Okay, all right. So just letting you know, if you are having trouble with having bowel movements, we can always have doctor's orders to help with the constipation, which constipation usually occurs because of the pain medication, such as narcotics that you may be taking, okay? And when's the last time you voided? You voided, okay. So every 2 to 3 hours you should be voiding to help keep the bladder, to help keep the bladder empty, because that prevents from the uterus to go from what's normal, which is midline, to go to the side, okay? All right, so every 2 to 3 hours, Jessica. Next is, we're just going to be looking at your legs. How's the, any pain behind your calves? Any pain? So what I'm looking at right now is any redness, tenderness. But you're saying that no pain around the, behind the calves. So that's good. No redness, no tenderness, no edema. All right. That's very good. The patient was calm, cooperative. Answered my questions. I'm also going to ask her how she's been with the baby, the family. How's the family? How's everything at home? And ask her if she's doing okay, how she's been after birth, during birth. How is she feeling? So you've been feeling great, Jessica? It's amazing. Also, I looked at your MR and I saw that you're immune to rubella, so that's good. You don't need to give you the shot, the immunization shot. But for Rogan, if the baby is positive and you're negative, we'd have to give you the shot. But if your baby's negative, we wouldn't have to give the Rogan shot, okay? All right. If you need anything, Jessica, just let us know. We're here to help. If you need anything, I'm going to give you the call light. Okay, and that concludes our assessment. Thank you so much for letting me do the postpartum assessment, and then I'm going to document all my findings onto the computer. Okay, thank you.